Ben, you got a pretty sweet Instagram feed. You ready to check it out?
Yeah, let's do it. I don't know. I mean, I think it's pretty average, but let's see what you got. I don't know. It'd be fun.
First one, let's settle this debate.
What is the proper pronunciation of your hazelnut spread?
Nutella?
All right.
Nutella or Nutella?
Yeah, so my wife insists that it's Nutella because it's made of a hazelnut, like Nutella. But I've always said it Nutella. I mean, it just rolls off the tongue, Nutella. But we really couldn't even tell what the guy said in the video. So we called the headquarters of Nutella, and he was clearly a little bit confused by the question, but I don't know. I as many times as we replay it, we still can't settle the debate. She hears Nutella, I hear Nutella. It's like the gold or white dress or Yanni or Laurel. It's like one of those things all over again, you know what I mean?
So she's got some really good dart throwing.
Yes, so that's my mom, who she is in a darts league. And so she was showing us how it's done. You know, she's got the form locked in, scope out the target, and then let it fly.
All right, so now this is your wife.
Here we go.
She's throwing 57 on the radar gun.
That's some heat. I'm impressed by that. And clearly she was too, but all natural mechanics right there.
She was giving max effort.
Yeah, oh yeah, max effort right away. Just, I mean, she's just like me, you know, just doesn't know how to tone it down. Just let it rip every pitch.
Uh-huh. Next one. Yourself and your wife did a little painting. Very nice.
Yeah.
Very identical too.
Right.
Do you guys kid around about whose artwork is
better?
Well,
we did a little Twitter poll to see which one was more popular, and whichever one won, we were gonna hang it up in our room. And I'm pretty sure mine won that one, but for some reason she still didn't allow me to hang it up. She was like, no, mine's better. We're gonna hang up mine. So no, it was fun. You know, I'm not really the most artsy guy, so something different, you know, get out of my comfort zone, and another opportunity for her to show me that she's always right.
You know what you need to do?
What?
You need to get one of those picture frames where you can print out the tweet.
Yes.
With the results.
Frame that and hang it up right next to my picture just so she always knows. Yeah, there we go.
One day surprise her when she comes home.
Yes.
All right, so do a little cooking. Was this you?
Yeah.
Your wife? Who was this?
So that's one of my favorite meals to make. And yeah, we love to cook. That's one of our, you know, probably staple meals. It's pretty healthy. Ground turkey, rice. You know, it's we got a peanut butter sauce, like a pad thai type of sauce that we put it in, and then those rolls, that was my first time ever using them. They're kind of tricky. So they start out as just rock hard circles like a tortilla. You got to put it in the right temperature water, then, you know, lay it out, fill it up, then roll it up. But those things are delicious. Just one of my favorite things that I make.
So you showed off your skills with this.
Oh yes.
This was, yeah. I'm sure this is a nice creation.
Yeah. Oh man, that's about the peak of my creativity right there. I mean, it's Halloween, you know, might as well get the pumpkin involved.
Wait, so you carved out the entire pumpkin,
right?
And then you put in
a
bowl.
Yep, you got queso up top and then guac spilling out of his mouth. So
amazing.
I feel like Halloween is the right time to, you know, kind of go with the more gross looking food presentation, but it was a hit, you know, it's good.
Next, you love fishing.
Yeah.
And you catch some pretty big fish. Do you always catch fish this big?
And
what got you into fishing?
I wish I caught fish that big all the time. But no, I really didn't fish all that much growing up. You know, every once in a while we would go, but most of the time I don't catch any fish, or mostly smaller fish, but that was a fun trip.
Yeah,
it was even more fun eating those afterwards.
All right, so here's another big one.
Yeah.
And now, gotta point out, you got the Green Bay Packers hat on. Big Packers fan. So you're outside in the cold fishing, and you're also outside in the cold watching some football. You don't mind it being a Midwesterner, huh?
Man, that's growing up in Wisconsin, you know? You gotta learn to embrace the cold. Like, I think that game it was about 30 degrees for that. The fishing trip too, it was like in the mid 30s. So that, you know, when it's sunny in the 30s, it feels like a nice spring day to me.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, I don't know, it kind of helps for baseball too. Like, I never really get worried about the cold. You know, I've pitched through snow, pitched through sleet. Midwest weather. It's not quite, you know, ideal weather, but you just kind of learn to deal with it, you know?
Yeah,
make the most of it. But yeah, the Packers have always been my team. Just a fun, you know, fun thing to follow and be involved with in the off season.
Talking about all this cold weather, sometimes you do see some really nice stuff when you're out there fishing or out on the boat.
Yeah.
Like dolphin action.
Oh, that's what it's all about right there. You know, like that was one of the coolest things I've ever seen. And I'm big into marine life. Like, I don't know, for whatever reason growing up, like Free Willy was always my favorite movie. Like, I enjoyed watching the Titanic, still one of my favorite movies to this day. And I've been whale watching a few times, whale watching up in Alaska and Cape Cod, but then, you know, seeing these dolphins in spring training last year, it's just unreal. Seeing those things up close, so fun. Oh, here
we go. You always get your workout in, no matter where it is. Yeah. Where is this?
So this is in Colombia, Medellin, Colombia, vacation that I went on with my friends a couple years ago. We were, you know, just walking down the street, and obviously it's beautiful. You know, the town is kind of built into a mountain, and it just had this little park where you could get a lift in. So I was like, hey, perfect. You know, it's no days off.
Correct. No days off. You're even getting a nice workout in. You're kidding around with the caption.
Yeah.
While on a mission trip.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah. Yep. So that was last year as well. We went to Guatemala for a week. We spent some time at an orphanage and we were doing a service project. We were building basically little wood burning stoves for people in a remote village. Absolutely amazing experience. You know, I feel like, well, I've been lucky enough to go on a couple trips like that, you know, service trips, and I feel like I always get more out of it than the people we're going to help.
It's really amazing what you've been able to do, especially on these trips, and the impact that you've had on kids, adults, and being able to really cherish those moments, like you said, in those relationships. And when you look back and you see photos like this, what does that mean to you?
It makes me feel, it's kind of a cliche word, but humbled. Like, for me to have the opportunity to like go somewhere else and into somebody else's life, you know, that like these kids are at an orphanage, and that's their reality is, you know, that they're living at a big home at an orphanage. And for me to just be blessed, you know, in the ways that I am, and have the opportunity to go help them out and just show them love, like, it just makes me appreciate everything that I have, but also just shows me like how important it is to give back and to help those in need. I just think it's, you know, it's such an important thing to show love to others.
So with that platform that you mentioned, you have Instagram, which we've just looked at all these photos, whether it is giving back or going on a mission trip or showing off a fun video of going fishing, whatever it may be, what would you say is your favorite part about Instagram?
Yeah, I mean, I would just say it's like giving others kind of a glimpse into my life, and, you know, just sharing, like, sharing what I enjoy, and hopefully inspiring others to, you know, just kind of enjoy themselves. And social media to me, it's always like a double-edged sword too, because believe me, my life is not all about fishing, baseball, mission trips. Like, I have plenty of ugly moments in my life, plenty of boring moments, you know, just day-to-day mundane things. But we tend to kind of show our highlight reel on social media, which I think is good and bad. But yeah, I mean, it's a fun way to kind of, you know, interact with the fans and show them what I'm like off the field.
Why should fans follow you, and what do you have to offer?
Oh man, I mean, I don't think I'm that interesting of a guy, but, you know, hopefully I can, you know, give you a little entertainment and be able to connect with you a little bit, you know, show you what my life is like off the field.